Hello guys and welcome to my channel. My name is Jesper Offersen and today we are going to talk about sunscreens. We are going to talk about sunscreens in a little bit of a different way than we are normally talking about sunscreens. Because today we are going to talk about how can you actually mattify any sort of sunscreen really in the way that the manufacturers they are doing it. Because there is a lot of sunscreens out there that promise that they will keep your skin mattified or non-greasy and so on. I mean, we have this one here, which is an anti-shine or anti-brillance from La Roche-Posay, and that is an SPF of 50+. It could be a little bit kind of like, if you have something that is an SPF of 50, then it might be a little bit more shiny than something that is just an SPF of 30, because there is a lot more filters in something that is an SPF of 50+. So this one here from La Roche-Posay, they say that it is an anti-shine, and we have tried this one here, so you can see a video about that up here. So this one here, it does actually have an ingredient in it, which is common in those sunscreens that are promising to keep your skin matte, and that is silica. And you have heard about that before, I'm pretty sure. When you are looking into powders and stuff like that, you might come across setting powders, and some of them they contain silica. And you might also come across something which is called a finishing powder, which is something you use at the last layer, and you don't use that much of it, but they will usually contain a whole lot of silica as well than as a setting powder, but they might contain a little bit more, and therefore you should use a little bit less, which you also normally do when you're using a finishing a powder. You don't want a whole lot. It's just kind of like a sheer layer that you put on at the last moment. So in another product from La Roche-Posay we have here, they don't say that it is an anti-shine thing as such, but it doesn't really leave your skin that shiny compared to something like this one here from La Roche-Posay, which is an SPF of 30, that this one here is an SPF 30 as well. But this one here, it does not contain a silica, and this one here does contain a silica. So the difference is that you have three products here. You can see you have this one here, you have that one, and then you have this one here, and this one here contains the most, I'm pretty sure, of silica compared to this one, and this one here contains the least. So it doesn't contain anything really. So the thing is, I have tried, and you can maybe remember that I showed a little picture on the community tab where I had mattified a sunscreen, and the sunscreen I used was this one here from La Roche-Posay. And when you see the review on it, you will see that it is a little bit to the shiny side. So I really wanted to use this as sunscreen, so I had to come up with some sort of idea. And before, I have just tried with a normal setting powder, kind of like the one I normally use from Laura Mercier, and there are other people like can hear that are saying they have also used a setting powder in the past. Now the way I use a setting powder is that I use it on top of the sunscreen, and that is kind of like the way you would supposed to use it, though that it is normally for a makeup cream instead, so for a foundation, but it kind of like applies the same way. So what I actually did when I was using this one here was that I applied it first. I applied the setting powder first. Well, it was actually not a setting powder, but it was something that you normally find in a setting powder, or at least something that you find in a finishing powder. And that is a product like this, and that is simply a raw silica. And that goes an awful long way. There is 50 grams in this one here, and it will last me, I mean, decades, I think. So unless I spill it all over the floor or something like that, but it could happen. So we just open it. One thing is that there is a silica in a lot of products, but there is actually just a little thing to say about a silica, and that is that in California they say that it is actually something that could potentially damage your lungs. So there is a little warning on silica in general. So that would be if you're using a setting powder with silica in it, or if you're using a finishing powder. Not so much if you are using something like this, because then it is in a cream already. It is more like when you have powders going on. So silica is in a lot of cosmetic products, so that's kind of like something you should in general think about. So what I do is that I basically just hold my breath while I'm doing it, but you shouldn't kind of like really like dusty, but just to be on the safe side. So what I do is I will put some of this silica powder on this side here, and then we will add this sunscreen on top, and then we will add the sunscreen, the same sunscreen on the other side, and you can kind of like see the difference. So this is, I use this sort of a big brush here. So this is something that you can basically, I mean, a lot of finishing powders, they are rather expensive, but the basic, the trick in those ones is basically just silica. Without it, it would not give this sort of nice look when you are, for example, filming in a 4K situations as we are doing here. But if you are using silica for photography, you need to use it really sparingly, because else you will get these sort of white marks on your face, as we have seen on celebrities a lot of times. So we just dip it a little bit in here and then take the worst off. So this is an awful lot. So I take the lid here and just dab it on. It will kind of like not stick that well to the brush. It will kind of like fall off a little bit. So we just wag it a little bit like that. And then I would just, as I said, I set this side here, so we put it on this side here. So you kind of like want to make it evenly distributed, because you could also just take a little bit of it and then smear it into your sunscreen before you put it on. But there you risk that the consistency of the whole sunscreen will kind of like change rather a lot. So I would not do that. Here, when you are distributing it like in an even layer like here, you will get it mixed more evenly into the sunscreen. That would be kind of like as this one here. So on this side, I'm just at on top of the powder, and here we'll have it not on top of the powder. Maybe you can already see a little bit of a difference compared to when I have the silica on here and I don't have it on here, that the shine is a little bit different already. So. And it is pretty easy to distribute, even that you had put the powder on. And I would say before you add more powder, which I will do when it has dried up a little bit, I would just add a little bit, kind of like as if I were using a finishing powder, so very sparingly. But you will, it's a good idea to kind of like wait a little while in order to see how it actually reacts. And with the kind of sunscreen that you normally like, you kind of like see how much do you actually need, because this one here might need more than some sort of other sunscreen, and other sunscreens they might need more, kind of like some of those from Aven or P20, they might need a whole lot more. They are really, really greasy. So now you can maybe already see that the difference is that it's a little bit more shiny on this side here. And though the light here is a bit soft, if I go out in the sunshine, this side here will shine a whole lot more than that side there. So maybe now you can see that this side here is very much more matte, but it will be more and more matte. And actually, during the day, I felt that it was kind of like, it felt like the silica could actually take up more and more and more oil and grease and so on during the day. So actually the look was better and better and better as the day progressed. But still I could not wait for that. So when you see this side here, and you can see how this side here is, I hope you can see that, is much more shiny compared to this other side here, which has a more sort of a controlled sort of shine. Still, what I will do is I will go in with this powder puff, or this, it's not a powder puff, it is a brush again, and just take slightly less than I used it before. and take the worst off. And then I would just go in and dab it where I feel that the potential for having a lot of shine is the greatest. So that would be on the forehead. So kind of like just very light dusting. And then on the nose. Like that. And then I would just go in and brush it out. So we don't want it sort of too much cream in there. The eyebrows. There's a little bit of cream there, voila, like that. So now I guess you can see, at least I can see here in the mirror, that this side here is a lot more shiny than this side here. So if you see this side here, it's kind of like much more matte. And you see this side here, it is, I think you can see, a lot more shiny. So what actually happened when the time was passing during the day was that this side here became more and more kind of like less and less shiny. So actually I sometimes thought that if I had not put the extra powder on top, maybe it would just have been enough to have maybe a little bit more underneath and then mix it in like that. But silica, it has this lovely effect that actually makes your skin look really kind of like blurred and really sort of perfect kind of like. So it looks really nice, I would say. I'm pretty sure that if you look straight at here, you can see this side here is a lot more shiny than this side here. So there is a lot of powders out there, and setting powders or finishing powders, I would say they are very expensive. I think this one here, 50 grams, I think it was about $6 or something like that. This will last an awful long time, and that is exactly what they are using when they are making these sort of mattifying sunscreens. But I would say mix it on the skin as I have shown you here, and don't mix it in your hand, because you risk that you are kind of like altering the consistency too much of the sunscreen, because they have obviously measured how much exactly to put in and still get the correct SPF and all that sort of thing. So you don't want to mix it like that. Do it on your skin, or if you don't want to put it on your skin first, the powder here, then you can just use it on top as the finishing powder. But there you might need to use a little bit more. But this sort of a powder will not make any sort of white look. It will not make you look like a ghost. And there won't be any sort of stuff going into the lines or anything like that, because this stuff here basically is see-through. So yes, that was my tip on how to make any sort of sunscreen more matte, or matte in general. And I'm really happy to have found that solution, because I really like this one here, because it does not contain any sort of salicylic acid in it. So yes, that was my little trick as to how to make a mattified sunscreen. If you would like to see more of this sort of videos, please subscribe, hit the bell, and do all the things you must do in order to be notified when I upload more of this sort of videos. Thank you for watching. See you. Bye.